Hello, and welcome to the FireVoxel tutorials. In this tutorial, we will introduce FireVoxel's tools for MRI non-uniformity correction. We will provide a brief overview of the correction methods implemented in FireVoxel and demonstrate how to use them to reduce non-uniformity in liver MRI. Non-uniformity of image intensity is a common MRI artifact. It creates a smooth variation of signal intensity across the image that is unrelated to tissue properties. This artifact may be caused by the imperfections of the imaging technique or the patient's influence on the magnetic and electric fields. Non-uniformity is often unnoticeable to a human observer, but it may introduce errors into quantitative MRI methods, such as segmentation, registration, and dynamic modeling. To minimize these errors, it is often helpful to remove the non-uniformity artifact before analyzing images. We will start with an example of a non-uniformity artifact in liver MRI. Open a document with MRI images of the upper abdomen. This T1-weighted VIBE dataset has a noticeable non-uniformity artifact. The image is darker in the front and center of the abdomen and brighter towards the sides of the body. This artifact is particularly pronounced in the liver. Now let's look at how non-uniformity affects the signal distribution. We will do it by examining the image intensity histogram in the liver. Select a slice through the liver. For demonstration purposes, we will load a previously saved ROI with several areas or blobs drawn in the liver. To create a similar ROI, you can click New ROI 3D and use the paintbrush tool to draw several blobs in the liver. Now, activate your ROI layer and open the ROI statistics panel to examine the signal histogram. For a uniform organ, such as the liver, we expect to see a single, relatively compact peak. Instead, this histogram shows a series of peaks in a wide intensity range. To estimate the signal intensity variation across the liver, we will use the blob non-uniformity measure. The non-uniformity correction is expected to reduce the visual signal intensity variation, transform the histogram into a single, narrower peak, and reduce the non-uniformity measure. FireVoxel offers three methods for non-uniformity correction: the widely used N3 method and its variant N4, as well as FireVoxel's original method named BiCal. These methods are retrospective and estimate the non-uniformities directly without the need for additional acquisitions. These methods assume that non-uniformity is multiplicative, which means that the intensity of the acquired image at every point can be represented as a product of the corrected intensity and a spatially varying bias field. To find the corrected image, we need to estimate the bias field. Here, we will briefly explain the main internal steps of these algorithms and apply these methods to our liver MRI dataset. We will start with the N3 and N4 methods. N3, or non-parametric non-uniformity normalization, is the most commonly used non-uniformity correction method. The N3 method and its variant, N4, operate in the log transform space of the image intensities and bias field. These methods deal with the probability densities or, for discrete images, intensity histograms. The histogram of the logarithm of the bias field is assumed to be a zero-centered Gaussian. Here we will review the internal steps of the N3 and N4 algorithms. First, the image background is masked. This step is followed by an iterative block performed in the log transform space of the image intensities and bias field. The logarithmic transformation conveniently changes the multiplication to addition, but may run into problems in areas where signal intensity approaches zero, such as the air-filled background regions. Masking the background helps to minimize these potential issues. Within the iterative block, each iteration includes three steps. In step 1, the bias field histogram is estimated so that the corrected image is sharpened. This sharpening is achieved by applying the Wiener deconvolution filter to the image intensity histogram. The Wiener filter uses a Gaussian kernel with a full width at half maximum selected by the user. In step 2, the new estimate of the bias field is smoothed by fitting it with a three-dimensional B-spline field with a specified grid. The size of the grid controls the degree of smoothing. This grid size is typically about 200 millimeters for images acquired with a body coil, and smaller for images acquired with localized surface coils. In step 3, the termination criterion is tested against a specified threshold. In practice, the algorithm stops after a fixed number of iterations specified by the user. Once the iterations are completed, the bias field is extrapolated over the entire field of view. And finally, the original image is divided by the bias field to obtain the corrected image. Now, let's go back to our liver image set. FireVoxel includes a simplified and accelerated version of the N3 method. We will use it to correct the liver images. On the layer control panel, select the base image. Next, use the main menu and select Non-uniformity N3. This will open the N3 parameter panel. The key parameters here are the number of iterations, field smoothness in millimeters, determined by the size of the B-spline grid, and the full width at half maximum of the filtering kernel. Set the number of iterations to 75, field smoothness to 20 millimeters, and full width at half maximum to 0.2. We will start by examining the bias field map. Check the Output Bias Field box and click OK. This operation will create a new layer with the bias field map. This map captures the artifactual signal variation across the image. To generate the corrected image, rerun the N3 tool, but this time uncheck the Output Bias Field. This operation creates a new layer with the N3 corrected image. Compared to the original image, the N3 corrected image is more uniform, as we can see on slice view and on film view. We can verify whether this visual improvement is reflected in the intensity histogram. On the layer control panel, hide the original image, check the corrected image and the ROI layer, and open the ROI statistics panel. Now, the image intensity histogram contains a single peak, and the non-uniformity parameter is about 5 times lower than in the original image. And here is another look at the N3 corrected image alongside the original acquired image. Next, we will use the N4 correction method. Make sure that the base image is active. Then, select Non-Uniformity N4. This will open the N4 parameter panel. Similarly to N3, the key parameters here are the number of iterations, the spline distance, which determines smoothness, and the full width at half maximum. This operation will create a new layer with the corrected image. Now open the ROI statistics. The histogram of the N4 corrected image shows a single peak, and the non-uniformity is reduced by about 6 times compared to the original image. Click OK. And here is the N4 corrected image next to the original image and the N3 corrected image. Now we will move on to the BiCal method. BiCal is a powerful and computationally intensive method that is best suited for challenging imaging tasks, such as high-field imaging or accelerated acquisitions. we will start by reviewing the main steps of the BiCal algorithm. First, the background signal is removed from the acquired image to create a background mask. The algorithm then detects sharp edges and creates an edge mask, a key step in this method. The next three action steps are performed in the log transform space of the image intensities and bias field, as in the N3 and N4 methods. In the first of these three steps, the partial derivatives of the image intensity are computed for each voxel of the body. The bias field is estimated as a set of smooth polynomial functions, and the partial derivatives of the bias field are fitted directly to the partial derivatives of the image signal intensity. The resulting set of linear equations is solved to obtain the polynomial coefficients that are used to estimate the bias field. Finally, the acquired image is divided by the bias field to obtain the corrected image. Now we will apply the BiCal method to liver MRI. Start by activating the base layer. Next, select Non-uniformity, BiCal. This will open the BiCal parameter panel. Here, the main parameters are the type of the basis functions, processing scale, which sets how many voxels are skipped to speed up processing, field precision, which sets the degree of polynomial expansion, and maximum correction, which limits the correction factor. Click OK. This operation will take a minute or two and create a new layer with the corrected image with substantially reduced non-uniformity. In the ROI statistics panel, we will see that the image intensity histogram shows a single peak, and the non-uniformity is about 15 times lower than for the original image. Now we can take another look at the BiCal corrected image compared to the original image and the N3 and N4 corrected images. Note that the BiCal correction preserves the contrast between the liver and spleen or muscle, whereas N3 and N4 methods reduce this contrast. This concludes this brief introduction into FireVoxel's non-uniformity correction tools. You can pick the most appropriate tool based on your application, required degree of correction, and processing time. For more information, please visit our website. Thank you.